Let us study the second method to solve ordinary differential equation, that is Euler's method. Now you have f of xy is equal to dy by dx. That is, dy by dx is nothing but function of x and y, where x is considered to be independent variable. Now my ideology behind Euler's method is that the new value of the function that is predicted by old value plus slope multiplied by step size. Now here you can see that this diagram represents the Euler's method. This you can see that there is a function curve, okay, and this is the derivative, which is nothing but the tangent to this line, okay, and the slope of this line is nothing but the derivative, that is dy by dx. Okay, so this we'll have y is equal to I plus 1 is equal to yi plus f of x I yi multiplied by h. Okay, so this is the basic formula for Euler's method. Now let's look at the flowchart for the method. So you to find out a solution with the help of Euler's method, you need a function, then you need to take initial value x0, y0 from the user, then at x is equal to xg, you need to find out what is the value of y, and you need a step size. Now step size is required to find out the number of iteration is equal to n. Now this is nothing but the iterative process in which you will repeat the calculation of the yg n number of times. By this is nothing but the Euler's formula. So yg is equal to y0 plus h into f of x0 y0. Now after evaluating, after each iteration you again need to assign the value of x yg to y0, and so that this loop is repeated n number of times. And after finishing this loop n number of execution of this loop n number of times, whatever the value of y is there, you print it as a final value yg. This is what the flowchart of Euler's method. Now let's understand it with the help of example. So this is the example 5x dy by dx plus y square minus 2 is equal to 0. Initial condition is given y4 is equal to 1. We need to find out value of y at x is equal to 4.1 and x is equal to 4.2, taking h is equal to 0.05. Now first we need to find out, to solve this by Euler's method, first we need to find out number of iterations, that is n is equal to 4.2 minus 4 upon 0.05 is equal to 5. That means in order to solve this problem with the Euler's method, we require 5 iterations of Euler's formula. Now we have dy by dx. Let's restructure this equation. Dy by dx is equal to minus y square upon 5x. Okay, and this is the initial condition. At x is equal to 0, at x0 is equal to 4, y0 is 1. Okay, so let's put it in the function. You'll get a function is evaluated, and then this evaluated function, let's put it in the formula of Euler's method. That is y1 is equal to y0 plus h into f of x0 y0. We'll find what is y1. Okay, so let's write this value y1 as 1.0025. Now as we need to repeat this 5 times, let's tabulate this value in a table. So this this table represents the iteration number, the value of xi, that is x0 plus h, every time it is getting incremented by 0.05, then the value of y, which you get after implementing the Euler's formula. And to get this value, whatever the function evaluation, that is tabulated in this table. So after repeating Euler's formula 5 times, you will get y at point 1 is equal to 1.0025. 0.50, okay, and y at point 2 is equal to 1.0097. Let's take another example. Here also we have a function, okay, and we need to solve it with the help of Euler's method. Okay, we need to solve this ordinary differential equation with the help of Euler's method. So we need to find it in 10 steps. Okay, so 10 steps are given, that is h is given, that is number of iteration is given, n is given, n is equal to 10. So by that you can find out what is the step size h. Okay, now let's start with the iteration number 1. Okay, so when you implement this formula, first Euler's formula, first time you will get y1 is equal to 2.069108. Now put keep this value of y1 as a reference, because this y1 will become y0 for the next iteration. Okay, so you can easily see that y2 is nothing but this y1, that is y2.069108 plus again 0.05 is nothing but the h, okay, that is the step size, and function evaluated at the new point. Okay, so let's repeat the calculation 10 times. Okay, so here 5 iterations are shown, rest of the 5 you can do it by your own, and after 10th iteration, that is at x10, that is xg, that is at x is equal to 1.8, you will get value of y as 2.578163.